So not all users are probably intimately familiar with what Nextcloud Text can do. So we added a suggestion bar for quick actions when you open an empty document. So you can link a file, you can upload a file, like an image, for example. You can also insert a table. And really cool, there's also the smart picker. So the smart picker can add all kinds of data content to your documents, like locations from a map, deck cards, AI-generated content, templates, all kinds of stuff. And well, when you have a document that has all these elements added, it can get a little complicated to move things around. So we also added dragging handles to objects to make it easier to reorganize your big documents with a lot of, you know, tables and other components. We also introduced smart typography autocorrect. I'll explain what it is. So sometimes you want to type like an arrow. So you do a dash and then the greater than sign, or you want to write a quarter. And you can now just type 1/4 and then Nextcloud Text will turn it into the character. So this just makes it easy to make all these symbols without having to, well, dig them up on the search engine, which is what I used to do. One more feature we improved a bit. This is one for the real fans of Nextcloud Text. So we have keyboard shortcuts, so you can use your hands instead of having to use your mouse all the time, which, yeah, is for some people a lot faster, right? And you can use these shortcuts to create headers, to create lists, to-dos, to insert quotes, yeah, lots of other components. And so with this release, we also added the ability to control links. So if you added a link and you want to show a preview of the link, you want to open the link, you want to maybe, you know, have a link to a document in there that should be editable right there in text. All of these things are now, yeah, controllable from shortcuts. So I think that's a nice extra, make Nextcloud Text a little bit more efficient for them. So all these improvements are also coming to the other apps that basically use text. So you have a number of applications, Deck, for example, and the Notes app that use text as a text editing component. So that means that all these things you can use there as well. And that's also true for collectives.